The 8088 MPH demo in composite CGA on a VGA monitor running on a non-IBM PC. How is this even possible? Spoiler alert, it's the MCE. Today we are talking about a fantastic new gadget. Yeah, I know, all my gadgets that I'm testing here are fantastic. But this one I will use every week from now on. This is the only device I need to connect all of my old PCs to a modern HDMI monitor or a VGA CRT monitor. It's the MCE2HDMI from Serdashop, once again. So, what makes this gadget so great? Well, let's answer that by showing you what it can do. Here is my beloved Euro PC. It's perfect for this demonstration because it can produce monochrome Hercules, CGA and Plantronics. If you don't know Plantronics, check out my video on that. Short story, Plantronics gives you 16 colors in 320x200, just like EGA does. Let's start off with something easy. CGA 4 colors. Wow, that is sharp. The pixels are super sharp. But something is wrong. This is too clean. CGA didn't look like that on any of my CGA monitors. Let's try turning scan lines on by long pressing button number 1. That's more like it. So we know it's working with high-res CGA. Let's try Plantronics. Still great. Let's spice things up by using a CRT monitor. By using a HDMI to VGA adapter, also sold by Serdashop, we get a VGA signal for our VGA CRT monitor. Now it's starting to look like a true CGA monitor. We even get 16 colors in Plantronics mode. And if I did not know, I would have thought I was using a 17-inch CGA monitor. I don't know if that was ever made. Let's try Composite CGA. You know the CGA mode that uses NTSC artifacts to create color? Living in Europe, I did not know about this back in the days. So that meant that we missed out on having 16 colors on our CGA games. Before I show you CGA Composite, there are two things you need to know. By short pressing button 1, we enter the menu, and there are two settings here you need to know about. The first one is Profile. Here we choose the input signal. Since we are using CGA, we will go all the way down to Profile and make sure it's set on CGA New. There's also a choice for CGA old, but in my experience, most games are using CGA new. If you're using an EGA signal, choose EGA to get correct colors. This is how it looks if you choose EGA, but your signal is CGA. The other thing you should know about is the palette menu. When using CGA Composite, you could have situations where the composite colors are wrong. In that case, you go to this menu and change the artifact phase until the colors are correct. That's it. This is Bruce Lee. Fantastic fun game to play. It has a CGA composite mode. Let's long press button 2 to turn on NTSC artifact mode. When I started testing this device, I would never in my dreams think I would be able to get all these colors that the fantastic 8088 MPH demo could produce. But here we are. Part 3 crashed, and so did most of the other parts. But with some help from Jim Leonard, one of the guys behind the demo, I was able to edit the .exe file to skip the parts that did not work. This demo is hard-coded for the original IBM PC Model 5150. So I'm amazed that we were able to show something at all. Let's try Hercules mode. Here we are going into the BIOS and we are setting it to use monochrome mode. And for this machine, that is Hercules mode. This is a no-go. Well, not really. We just need to give the box some help. So by short pressing button 1, we enter the menu and we scroll down to profile, where we can choose Hercules mode. And bang, we have Hercules on a VGA CRT monitor. How cool is that? A quick adjustment of the monitor and we're there. Let's try a game, Blockout, one of my favorites from back in the days where I used Hercules graphics. If I remember right, my Hercules screen was amber. Let's go back into the menu and choose a different palette. We have green and amber. Not bad. Now this looks like my original Hercules monitor that came with this Euro PC. And for completion, here are some EGA 640x350 graphics. This is not recorded on my Euro PC, but on a Paradise EGA card in my West PC 1600. So, now we have a very good idea of what this box can do and how easy it is to get started. The MCE2HDMI is built on the RGB2HDMI project on GitHub. And the documentation there will answer all the questions you might have. But to make it work with CGA, EGA and Hercules, I have shown you all you need to know. But as you can see, there's a lot of settings to fiddle with, but I leave that up to you. Since the MCE2HDMI is based on the RGB2HDMI, I am wondering if this box can do other machines. After reading the documentation on different CPLD types, I believe that all of these machines listed on the screen now are theoretically supported. I believe that you could easily make cables for these machines and use them on the MCE2HDMI. If you try this or know anything about this, please let me know in the comments. To summarize, this box can take CGA, EGA, Hercules and even composite CGA as input and convert it to HDMI. Or even a VGA signal so that we can use it on a CRT monitor. This is a game changer for me. This gadget let me downsize my monitor collection. I don't need a CGA or a Hercules monitor readily available any longer. This VGA monitor can now be my only CRT monitor for older PCs and even my Commodore 128, at least for the RGBI output. And the best bonus I could wish for, I can now use my Euro PC or any other PCs with CGA or EGA to produce a composite CGA signal with all the colors. I can even choose to emulate both the new and the old type CGA composite. Should you buy it? For that price, it's nothing to think about. My only regret is that I did not test it out sooner. Well, that's it, folks. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, like and subscribe so you don't miss out on my next video about retro gadgets. Thank you for watching.